Hey guys, in this video we are going to talk about San Francisco, California's fourth largest city and home to the famous Golden Gate Bridge. San Francisco has a population of little more than 800,000, making it the 13th most populated city in the United States. But considering San Francisco's greater area, more than 4.6 million people are living here. San Francisco is situated in the Bay Area, bordering Daly City, Brisbane, the San Francisco Bay, and the Pacific Ocean. In addition, you can access Oakland by using the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge or the Upper Peninsula by crossing the Golden Gate Bridge. Speaking of the 1937-built Golden Gate Bridge, it has a total length of more than 2.7 kilometers and is 227 meters high, making it a remarkable eye-catcher of San Francisco. Over 120,000 cars are crossing the bridge daily. In order to make sure that the traffic doesn't jam, there is a flexible crash barrier installed on the bridge. Isn't that innovative? Another interesting fact is that the Golden Gate Bridge's color is called International Orange. Therefore, it actually is orange and not golden. But the Golden Gate Bridge is anyways not named by its color, but by the Golden Gate Strait, a narrow entrance between the Pacific Ocean and the San Francisco Bay. John Freeman, an explorer who arrived here back in 1846, saw a lot of similarities of the Golden Horn in Istanbul, Turkey, which is the reason for its name. Many believe that San Francisco lies only on a few hills, but there are a total of over 50 named hills. Some of the most well-known are Russian Hill, Knob Hill, Telegraph Hill, and Twin Peaks. A few of the lesser-known ones are Golden Mine Hill, Excelsior Heights, and Tank Hill. As a tourist, I was impressed by how hilly the city of San Francisco is. Filbert Street has a maximum gradient of 31.5% or 17.5 degrees, making it San Francisco's steepest street. Instead of a pavement, it has stairs for pedestrians to climb up the street. Additionally, cars park at a right angle to the pavement in order to avoid that cars suddenly start rolling down the street. Thanks to the hilly environment, there are a lot of places where you can enjoy an imposing view over parts of San Francisco. If you ask me, the view from places like Twin Peaks or Hawk Hill really are at the cutting edge. And at night, the experience is even better because there are less tourists around and you can enjoy the lights of the vibrant city. Let's talk about the climate here in San Francisco. When I first arrived in San Francisco, I really felt like I was in Italy. And it is no coincidence because the Mediterranean climate is present in a lot of parts of California. Therefore, the weather but also the vegetation is very similar to the ones in southern Europe. On average, there are just 48 days of rain during the whole year. And between June and September, there isn't even one full day of rain, which is very impressive. Many San Franciscans mention that the appearance of the sun and its light is special and unique. And it's true, sunrises and sunsets are mystical. However, the city of San Francisco is famous for its fog. That's why San Francisco is also referred as the fog city. But usually the fog is only present during the mornings and volatilizes at noon. Because of the Mediterranean climate, the wine industry is highly developed in the greater area of San Francisco and in California in general. And talking about the economy of San Francisco, you probably already knew that there are plenty of huge tech companies headquartered in San Francisco and its greater area. Adobe, Apple, Airbnb, Facebook, Google, IBM, Oracle, PG&E, Safeway, Symantec and Yahoo are just a few of many multi-billion dollar companies situated here. So if you are specialized in IT or in science in general, you will definitely find enough opportunities here. But besides all these humongous companies, the tourist sector still plays a significant role in San Francisco's economy. Over 3.9 million tourists visited San Francisco back in 2016, generating a turnover of more than $5.9 billion. What else can one explore in San Francisco? Distributed throughout the city, there are plenty of places where you can enjoy street art. Just take a look at these wonderful graffitis. Yet another tourist attraction worth seeing is Fisherman's Wharf. You can find tons of souvenir shops and restaurants there, but also a public museum where you can take a look at historic ships that were used several hundred years ago, but also modern ships can be observed here. While the city center of San Francisco for sure feels like a gray concrete jungle, San Francisco's southern neighborhoods are, in spite of California's warm climate, surprisingly green. San Mateo or Atherton are just some of them, but there are a lot of neighborhoods where rich people settled down. Therefore, you can find some pretty neat houses here. avenues look adorable in those neighborhoods. And thanks to a lot of old trees, you even find squirrels from time to time. They always look super busy, but this one definitely saw me. In San Francisco and the Bay Area in general, earthquakes and wildfires are a severe threat to the people living in this area. In 1989, a huge earthquake killed 63 people and resulted in 3,800 injured people. And back in the year of 1906, a giant earthquake killed over 3,000 people and destroyed 3/4 of the city of San Francisco. In addition to the earthquakes, the wildfires must not be underestimated. Every year, there are hazardous wildfires present, affecting residents living in the outskirts of San Francisco. Sadly, over 8,500 wildfires killed more than 100 people just in the year of 2018. And in some areas of San Francisco, one can smell and see the smoke of those fires. Based on that, it's no rarity to see people wearing air-filtering masks. USA and culture, you may think that this doesn't fit, but San Francisco clearly proves opposite. Therefore, let us talk a bit about San Francisco's culture and people. During the Gold Rush, about 180 years ago, a lot of immigrants came to California and also to San Francisco, seeking for a better life with more freedom and opportunities that they had in their home countries. And because San Francisco transitioned from a city characterized by the Gold Rush to one of the world's most innovative tech hubs, again a lot of foreign people settled down in this area to build their startups and to benefit from the large US American market. Following the diverse population, the city emerged to one of the most liberal cities on the planet. The residents of San Francisco are known to be open-minded, accepting and tolerant. Also, it holds big LGBT equality and anti-war movements. But some also say that locals in San Francisco are much more focused on work and seem less chilled compared to people living in other Californian cities. People seem to be nice at first glimpse, but then one realizes that they in most cases are quite superficial. San Francisco's unique culture can also be observed in the local city laws. While San Francisco banned the implementation of public facial recognition, it legalized the consumption of cannabis and other THC-containing products. San Francisco hosts the largest Chinese ethnic enclave outside of Asia. The San Francisco Chinatown is world famous. Moreover, San Francisco's Japantown is considered one of the largest and oldest ethnic enclaves in the United States. But to be honest, if you want to experience Chinese and Japanese towns in the most authentic way, you better book a flight to these countries directly. And usually in October, you can enjoy the San Francisco Fleet Week, which is a public air show presenting fighter jets, passenger aircrafts and aerobatic planes. This is a nice event for airplane enthusiasts, but also for families and children. You might heard that San Francisco is stuck in a severe housing crisis. Because of urbanization, everyone wants to live close to the city center, resulting in astronomically high housing prices. So you can quickly find yourself in the position of spending a huge chunk of your monthly salary for covering your rent. But one thing that I experienced during my stay in San Francisco is that a lot of valuable space gets wasted. Houses are not as tall as in European cities, and especially in the suburbs, houses tend to have just one flat. Nevertheless, there are some uniquely colored houses and real architectonic masterpieces to see. As you already heard, living in San Francisco is expensive. For the amount of money you have to spend to live in San Francisco for a month, you could stay in London for 5 weeks, in Berlin for 2 months, and in Istanbul for 4 months. In spite of all these positive aspects of San Francisco, there unfortunately are some downsides when it comes to living here. Public transportation is very poor. It is impossible to get around the neighborhoods without using a car. And the few trains that are in operation are not powered by electricity, but by diesel engines. Furthermore, and sorry to all San Franciscans, but I have to mention it, there are tons of homeless people situated in the city. There are some neighborhoods where you see tents and people consuming drugs in public. Moreover, I experienced the smell of poop in some city districts, which affected my stay as a tourist in a negative way. And all the waste and garbage near the highways is absolutely distasteful. To sum up, the city of San Francisco, its climate, culture, economy, and people are a must-see, and it is definitely worth to visit it at least once in your lifetime. Have you ever visited San Francisco? What were your impressions? Please let me know in the comments. And if you have some more ideas about which cities or countries I should cover next, please leave a comment. And don't forget to subscribe in order to not miss any new videos about the world's most interesting cities and countries. And don't forget to activate the bell so that you get notified every time a new video about an interesting city appears. Thanks for watching. Thank you.